Hey everybody, this is Nick, and last week we talked about importing data from a PDF into Excel using just a picture. So you're getting data from the picture. So I'm going to quickly do that really fast right here. We just used a screen snipping tool to highlight this, take a screenshot of these satisfaction scores in PDF, and we go back to that snipping tool just to make sure it is copied. Oops, let's see, where's my snipping tool? Where'd it go? Oh, there it is. Okay, so there's the snipping tool. I just got to make sure to copy it and put it on my clipboard. Now, here in Excel, we can go to the Data tab, say from Picture, and then from Clipboard, and then it does a little bit of thinking all the way up to 100%, and it gives you a few little errors here just to correct January. I'm going to correct that, and then down here we have, let's see, April. And this one was May, and we'll accept that. And the 90%, that's fine, so we'll accept that. So there's just four errors here, and actually this one's barely an error, so there's just four little errors that we needed to insert there, and we'll say insert. Perfect, so that looks nice. Remember, we were just gonna clean this up, delete that, have a nice little data table right here. We can delete that too. Perfect, make these bold. Looks like a gorgeous data table. But I wondered if lots of times we don't have a beautiful PDF that's so clear like this. Sometimes we have like a scanned copy or a faxed PDF, something that was scanned and copied before, and it kind of looks like this. So I wanted to see how Excel would treat it if I did the same thing with that. So we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna screen snip this, and we will just enter that, make sure we get back there, put that on my clipboard. Let's go ahead and enter this data, go back to the Data tab, click on From Picture, From Clipboard, and now it's gonna do some thinking for us, and we'll see, let's see if I can maximize this, we'll see how many errors we have. So we have the top error, but we can accept that, that looks okay. I'm gonna accept that. Any of the cells that are pink, you can go ahead and kind of rectify that way. So month January, it looks like this one didn't quite do the year 2023. It looks like there's a decimal there, so I have to go ahead and correct that. A lot of pink cells here for blanks, and actually it didn't even carry over my years for 2022. So you really have to be careful about some of these, 2021, about some of the things that pop up here. You can see some of the data doesn't even populate in over here. So you're really gonna have to go through and see where that, which ones of those data, which data points you really need to put in here. So it doesn't look like it imported. Some of the words are okay. Some of the words are a little bit choppy. And then some of the cells are missing some of that data. So this is just a little word of caution when you are inserting data into PowerPoint from a PDF using that data tab feature from Picture, using that get data from Picture feature. So I just wanted to kind of test that out and see how it looked. It looks like it's not quite as perfect for us, and you can imagine if you had a really big PDF with a lot of data, how much time you might spend sort of going through and correcting it. So not all fixes work 100% of the time. So just wanted to share that one, and let me know in the comments how you have dealt with sort of bad PDF copies and trying to put them into Word. Hope you all have a great day. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.